charcoal bath bombs. What the fuck? Hey guys, welcome to Bath Fizz and Foam, where today we don't need a scale. The rules for what the fuck are that we have to follow a Pinterest or a recipe that we found online, and we have to follow exactly as it is written. So that's what we're going to be doing today. And we're going to be making some black bath bombs with activated charcoal. We need 2 cups of baking soda, 3/4 cups of citric acid. I normally weigh my ingredients, but these were written as volumetric, so that's what we're doing. 1/4 cup of SLSA. That's a lot of SLSA, just saying. 1/4 cup of cream of tartar. And I just have to cut in here to say that the recipe actually also included 1 cup of cornstarch, and I did not include that. So I do have some issues with it being sticky later on, and that could be why. That doesn't mean that it would have affected the charcoal though. All right, so back to the actual recipe. It says to mix, so we are gonna be mixing. I normally sift my ingredients because my baking soda, my citric acid, those ingredients, even cream of tartar, can have little lumps in them. So what I'm doing now is I'm mixing all the stuff together, and I'm having to try to go through and find all the little lumps that were in the recipe, but the recipe didn't say to mix, to sift it, so I couldn't sift it. Okay, so I'm cleaning my gloves off, but there is 1/3 cup of coconut? Coconut oil. 1/3 cup of coconut oil. And this is one of the reasons I don't like coconut oil or measuring by volumetric, because look how messy it is. Okay, then we have to melt our coconut oil, and then we are going to add polysorbate 80, and I do have to give this recipe credit for having polysorbate 80 as an ingredient. Most of the free recipes I found online didn't have it, and y'all need it. The recipe called for 10 to 20 drops of cardamom and rosemary essential oils. I didn't have cardamom, so I substituted it with lavender essential oil. And it says to mix these together, so it says mix well, so that's why I want to show you. I mixed it well. It says add the oil mix to the dry mix and blend everything together, so I'm going to do that. And once it's all mixed in there, it's not quite as airborne, so, that's good news. But I did have to mix it by hand, and I hate doing that. This is why I use a stand mixer now, but hey, the recipe, it's okay. It's a small recipe. I don't mind doing it. So it says to add in 1 tablespoon of activated charcoal, and then, it says start by adding 1 tablespoon of activated charcoal. And then once I blend it, if I want it darker, I can add a bit more. So it doesn't really clarify what a bit more is. So I'm just going to have to like go with my gut on it, but I do give it like plenty of time to mix in. So I just, want to make sure I'm having to break up all those little clumps of oil and make sure that the whole mix is colored. I don't want to leave anything uncolored. And at that point, I decide, okay, it's not going to get any darker than that. It's a gray and it's not black, and I want it black. So I did 1/2 tablespoon of activated charcoal. So total is 1.5 tablespoons of activated charcoal. And you can see it's getting nice and black now. I am having to mix a lot. A lot. I hate mixing by hand. My hands lost the will to live right there. They were like, we're done with life. But I saw it through. I was determined. I saw it through, and I mixed all the way until it was ready to be molded. And I do have to say, despite the fact that I left out the cornstarch in this recipe, it was actually pretty easy to work with to mold. I do have issues with it sticking to the metal molds that I use, but that's probably because of the cornstarch. So that actually makes sense now. Like at the time, I was like, I've never seen this happen before. What is going on? But it kind of makes sense. If there's no cornstarch in there, the mix is going to be a little bit wetter, and then it's going to stick to the molds. It's just interesting because I've never seen mix stick like this to metal molds. But overall, I give this recipe full marks. Like this, if it weren't for the activated charcoal, I would say that this is like a B+ recipe. That's not full marks, is it? I would say this is a B+ recipe. And like, it would get an A if it had its ingredients separated by weight. I'm not a big advocate of having your ingredients as 1 cup, 2 cup, 3 cup, because you know, you're like, my measurement of a cup, is it a heaping cup? Is it a level cup? You know, it's just, it can be different for everybody. So that's one of the reasons. It also doesn't suggest sifting the ingredients, which that's another important thing, especially if you are going to do volumetric, because then if I have a cup of sifted baking soda, that's going to be a lot more baking soda than a cup of clumpy baking soda where, you know, there's going to be kind of air pockets and stuff like that in there. So it's honestly, though, that's like a minor thing compared to a lot of recipes I found. So I don't mind, that, honestly. As far as the recipe goes, though, it was pretty solid recipe. I do feel like the amount of cream of tartar and SLSA was like intense. That's a lot. SLSA and cream of tartar are the most expensive ingredients in a bath bomb recipe, and they had a quarter cup. That is so much. So I really feel like they probably could have cut back on it. So there's what I'm talking about, where it's like started to stick to the mold. It's kind of interesting to me. I'm curious now as to whether or not the cornstarch would have made the difference so that it didn't stick in there. I may give this recipe another shot later without the charcoal, because we're not doing the charcoal again. That's not happening again. This was a one shot deal. That's it. We're never doing charcoal again. Okay, just letting y'all know right off the bat, like, this is not happening again. But yeah, I'm just interested to, I might come and revisit this recipe. I probably would cut back on the amount of cream of tartar. I just feel like it's way too much, and it's such an expensive ingredient. Just like SLSA. SLSA is about $10 a pound. So if you kind of put that in perspective, I think baking soda is like 3 cents a pound. Three cents. Which is fine. I mean, you have to buy it in bulk, and it's not like, you know, it's just like you just don't need that much. You know, you just don't need that much. I think in my recipe that makes 12 full bath bombs, I think it has like 40 grams of SLSA. 40 grams, which is like an ounce, which I don't know how that would measure in a measuring cup, but it's not a quarter cup. Or I don't know. I may have to volumetrically measure it now just to be sure. But it's just a lot. It's just a lot. That was my only thing. Like, you just don't need that much in your recipe. But other than that, it was actually a pretty solid recipe. I think you'll see later on the bath bombs actually float, which is like, I mean, I don't care that much about floating, but a lot of people do. So, you know, if you care about floating, they did float. So that's cool. It made some really pretty bath art in the tub. It had lots of really pretty foam that was like big fluffy foam, but it was also fast. So that's cool. But as far as the activated charcoal goes, now there's a reason I don't use activated charcoal in my bath bombs, and they stain the tub. It stains the tub. I mean, but I was like, okay, I've never actually tried it with polysorbate 80. Let's give it a shot. But I wrote an article for black bath bombs, to make black bath bombs with using lake colorant, and it's probably our most shared article on our blog on Bath Fizz and Foam. And the thing is that you don't have to use, you can get nice jet black bath bombs without having to use activated charcoal. So, you know, I just wanted to, what the fuck is just like, I just wanted to see, like, you know, I just want to play with other recipes. So I'm just going to like be doing this. I hope to do it like once a week, and I'm probably going to destroy my guest bathroom. Because I just plan on making these bath bombs once a week, and this is the first one I wanted to do, but the second one that I've already done, it's just as terrible, but like in completely different ways, but it's also terrible, and that one I believe that I followed the recipe to a T. Okay, so here's what's weird to me.
God. Oh my God. What? Oh, gross.
So I don't know why. I don't know why. And the missing cornstarch is not going to make a difference here. these bath bombs smelled like sulfur. It smelled like sulfur, like eggs, like sulfur. And like, look at the texture of this. I may have to revisit it just because of the missing cornstarch. I just don't feel like that would have made that big a difference. But it has had something to do with the charcoal itself. It was like gritty, like you could feel it. Now I'm sticking my hands in this mix because I want to see if it'll rinse off my hands. And I was surprised it rinsed off my hands. So I was, at this point, I'm like second guessing myself. I'm like, maybe you can use charcoal in the bathtub. I don't know. That foam is really intense, but it almost had like a jelly-like consistency to it. That was really strange. But it did rinse off. It did rinse off my hands pretty easily. So that was just kind of an interesting little side thing that happened right there. And yeah. The black bath bombs are done. They've been sitting for 2 days. It's time to go test them. Come on, we're testing you now. What? Yeah. Come on, little lady. You're gonna get tested by the Lord. This is our test bathroom. It's my kids' bathroom. It's not the cleanest bathroom in the world. Sorry, I have laundry hanging. This is every bathtub in America. A little bit of filth or in the tub. You're welcome. Let's test this baby. Okay, so we put the bath bomb in the tub, and as you can see right off the bat, it's floating. It's making some pretty nice foam, and the color is dispersing nicely in the bathtub.
So I kept the water below that area, so that area was already there and stained, so anything that's on this new area will be stained. It is stained. So maybe not stained. I might just be freaking out for nothing, okay?
You know what this reminds me of? When I got bit by a spider one time, and I was like, oh no, it's getting bigger. So I was like, I'm gonna draw a circle around it with a Sharpie so that if it gets bigger, then I can tell. And in the morning, I woke up and my entire arm was red from my shoulder to my elbow. And so I didn't even need that stupid circle. Yeah, that's about like what this is, so.
All right, moment of truth.
So that's not a good start, having the little stopper be kind of covered with activated charcoal, but I'm gonna reserve judgment until everything's done. So, you know, okay, now that was, I knew, I could see right there that was gonna be a problem, that little line where there was charcoal. I knew that was gonna be a problem. I just didn't know at the point. Like, I honestly, at this point, because I'd stuck my hands in it a couple times and I didn't have any residue on my hands, I was literally second guessing myself. I was like, maybe I've been freaking out about people putting activated charcoal in their bathtubs for no reason. Maybe I've been freaking out for no reason. Maybe.
Bro, what the fuck?
No. All of my fears were justified. Activated charcoal doesn't matter, even if you use polysorbate 80. If that is the only thing that you're using to make your bath bombs black, it's not a good idea. As an additive to a black bath bomb, I don't know. But if that's the only thing you're using to make your bath bombs black, nope, don't do it.
Why did I do that?
The answer is that I did it in the name of science for all of my bath friends forever, my BFFs, and now I get to spend the next 30 minutes cleaning my bathtub, which I show you some of that adventure as well. Like, okay, cleaning. I took about like 3 or 4 rounds of like cleaning. I'd have to like let the cleaner sit, scrub it, rinse it. I would find more spots, let the cleaner sit, rub it, scrub it, all that stuff. And I mean, my deal is like, can you imagine a customer having this experience if you sell your bath bombs, or even a friend, if you give them to a friend? Like, can you imagine?
ever again. You're welcome. I did it so you don't have to.
Now, all that is not to say that I don't love black bath bombs. In fact, it's one of my favorite things to do is to make black bath bombs just because it's so fun. So I will share a link in the description to our color study for black bath bombs. And this is a free color study that we have just to help you out, because I don't want that to happen to anybody. Like, that's like savage. It's ridiculous. Like, no, that should never, you never want to have that happen to your bath. So yeah, I will include a link to our black color study. And yeah, if you would like to, you should like and subscribe for more videos. I hope to be doing some more what the fucks. And come join our Facebook group, Bath Fizz and Foam, Bath Bomb, and Bubble Bar Support Group, because we want to see your happy mug there. And as always, happy making.